church, standing by the railroad track, just a shabby little place where we used to sing Amazing Grace. I'm talking about a good time. Well, church, a mighty, mighty good. Listen, listen. Some deacons would throw up a tent in an old field. Folks could come from everywhere, traveling over rocks and rails. Not a lot of money was raised, but many, many souls were saved. I'm talking about a good time. Well, church, mighty, mighty good. Well, take me to the water. Take me to the water. Take me to the water, yeah, to be baptized. Well, I love Jesus. I love
Yes, Lord.
Dennis, your saint.
Yes, Lord.
Right before us on this day.
Yes.
Getting ready to be baptized.
Amen.
He had told his mom he wanted to be baptized, and they discussed baptism.
Yes.
And as we shared with him, he loves the Lord. He wants everyone to know that I believe in Jesus.
Yes.
And because of that, we're going to take him down in the water. The water is not what cleanses him, and the water doesn't save him. It is one of the orders we do, because thus saith the Lord.
Yes.
But he has taken this voyage, and we're going to witness the mighty hands of God. In the name of the Father, and in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost, we anoint our beloved brother.
He's my Savior. My Savior, he my Savior, yes he is. Well, none but the righteous, none but the righteous, none but the righteous shall see God. Well, take me to the water. Thank you, God. Yes.
An emotional.
Yes.
Sister Brenda Louise Scott.
Yes.
That's standing right here, right here.
Yes.
She said, Pastor, I've been baptized before, but it's something that's happening on the inside of me that's working on the outside. My life has changed. And I just want to go down in this water.
Yes.
And when she came forth in remembrance of her daughter.
Yes.
Who has succumbed to cancer. What a mighty day to see.
Yes.
She's saying, I still believe in the Father.
Yes.
I still believe in the Son.
Yes.
And I still believe in the Holy Spirit.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Yeah. Yes, Lord.
We take this sister down?
Yes, Lord. Bless the name of
Jesus. Died and he was resurrected.
Yes. Bless the name of Jesus.
Water, she just said, God,
yes,
I
Lord.
I thank you. I thank you.
I love Jesus. I love Jesus. I love Jesus. Yeah. Yes, I do. He's my Savior.
can see a little old church standing by the railroad track. Just a shabby little place where we used to sing Amazing Grace. I'm talking about a good time where church almighty. Listen, listen, listen. Some deacons would throw up a tent in Oldville, and folks would come from everywhere, traveling over rocks and rails. Not a lot of money was raised, but many, many souls were saved. Talking about a good time with church, a mighty church. Come on, say hallelujah, church.
Hallelujah.
You see, scriptures tells us when one go down, the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And we ought to be able to rejoice right now. Say hallelujah, church.
Hallelujah.
Say hallelujah.
Well, good morning, church. Good morning, church. Good morning, church.
Good morning.
I just want to make sure I'm at Antioch East Baptist Church. Please prepare your hearts and minds for this beautiful devotion. We will have a song that will be coming from our patriarch, Deacon Patterson. We are climbing Jacob's ladder, Deacon Patterson. And we'll have a scripture that will be coming from Gary, the night chef, Hargrove, as soon as he can come on. And then we're going to have a song by Brother Favors. And then we're going to turn it over to the worship leader. So again, prepare your hearts and minds for the devotion on this fourth Sunday. Deacon Patterson. right, church, please give Brother Favors a hand. Give him a hand, please. Give him a hand. And again, Deacon Pastor, thank you for leading us off. And Brother Hargrove, thank you for that scripture. So, church, please again lend your hearts, your minds, and your souls to this wonderful service that we have on today. We will now turn the program over to our wonderful worship leader, Reverend Mom McWhorter. Thank you.
Amen, amen, amen. Let's give this male choir a hand, a round of applause. As they were singing to the glory of God, and I thank them for our devotion this morning. I also want to take this time to thank our musician, Dr. Marsha, and also our drummer, Brother Marcus. As we give honor to the Lord God Almighty, who is the head of all of our lives, we also give honor to our senior pastor, the Reverend Dr. Michael A. Smith, our First Lady, Patricia Smith, to these deacons, mothers, everybody under the sound of my voice. I just give thanks, glory, honor, and praise to the Lord God Almighty. And you know, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord, because the God is in his holy temple. We have to understand that the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit, lives right here. He also dwells where else? Right here. Yes. So when we come in the door, we're bringing our spirit in to meet with the Holy Spirit. So we ask the Lord God Almighty to have his way. I just say thank you, Lord God Almighty. And like they just finished singing, we're down here, Lord, and we are waiting on him. We are waiting for the Holy Spirit to take over and do what he does. But you all know I try to remind you constantly that he is a what? He is a gentleman. And we have to invite him. And when we invite him and we submit to him, hallelujah, he will have his way. So I just say thank you. And I thank the Lord God Almighty for each one of you here today. And I thank him for those that are joining us online. And I thank him for those that will hear and see this worship experience even after today. So to God Almighty be the glory. And now we will get ready for our responsive reading. And if you will please rise to your feet. And as you know, I will read the first verse, you will read the second, and we all will read the eighth verse together. And our responsive reading is coming from the book of Psalms. And it's the 61st chapter, verses 1 through 8. And the first one says, to the chief musician upon Nima, a psalm of David, hear my cry, O God, attend unto my prayer. For thou hast seen a shelter, for thou hast been a shelter for me, and a strong tower from the enemy.
I will abide in thy tabernacle forever. I will trust in the number of thy priests.
For thou, O God, hast heard my vows. Thou hast given me the heritage of those that fear thy name. He shall abide before God forever. Oh, prepare mercy and truth, which may preserve him, all of us together. So will I sing praise unto thy name forever, that I may daily perform my vows. May the Lord add a blessing for the readers, hearers, and doers of his holy word. You may be seated. And now we will have our welcome and announcements from our courtesy guild. Amen.
Good morning, Antioch East Baptist Church. Sorry. I said, good morning, Antioch East Baptist Church. All right, that's better. It is such a blessing to see all your beautiful faces here today. Now, well, at this time, all of our visitors, please stand. I am so glad that you chose to worship with us today. You could have gone anywhere else, but we are honored that you chose to worship with us today. Now, I have a few questions for you, and this will take some participation from everyone. So, everyone, get your hands ready. Raise your hand if when you walked in, you were greeted with a smile. Okay. And raise your hand if someone said hello to you. Okay, all right, we're doing good. And raise your hand if you got a chance to meet someone new, received a handshake, or a hug. Oh, Antioch, we did that. We did that. All right. Great job, Courtesy Guild and our Antioch family. We are doing our job. On behalf of our esteemed pastor, Dr. Michael A. Smith, and our elegant First Lady, Patricia Smith, we are delighted that you are here to worship with us today. We consider ourselves more than just a congregation. We are a family. We believe in showing up for one another, supporting each other through our life's ups and downs, and loving deeply as Christ loved us. No matter where you're going, where you're coming from, we want you to know that you have a place here at Antioch East Baptist Church. We'd love for you to become part of our family and join as we grow together in faith, love, and service, and considering making this your church home. We pray that you feel God's love and presence here today. So, Antioch East, let us stand and show them and our cyber visitors how glad we are that they joined us here today.
The Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. The Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. So easy.
All right, family, we sound good. Announcement for this week are as follows. Men's Day 2025 meeting. There is a Men's Day meeting today in the Women's Sunday School class. Meetings will be held every fourth Sunday of the month to provide updates on the plans and events for Men's Day 2025. Thank you in advance, Chairperson Deacon Garrett Skelton and Co-Chairperson Brother Alvin Patton, my dad. Coming soon, the first time Antioch Historical Gallery. On November 3rd and 10th, our artifacts will be on display to inform our new members about our history and remind our mature members of our beginning. He truly has brought us from a mighty long way. Please be advised that the church conference has been rescheduled for November 23rd from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. All members, please mark your calendars. Join us for our first annual youth musical that will take place on November 14th from 6:30 p.m. to 8 o'clock p.m. And admission is free. Now, on yesterday, we held our 24th annual Mothers Conference, and it was amazing. God was truly in this place. And speaking of place, did I forget to tell you that Antioch East won first place, winning the Glowing Light Sojourner Award yesterday? The first time in 24 years. Congratulations, Mother Beale, and the Antioch East Mothers Board for hosting a successful Mothers Conference yesterday. The Courtesy Guild Ministry is celebrating their 57th anniversary today. Will all Courtesy Guild members please stand? Thank you. Happy anniversary. The outreach ministry will meet right after service today for an important meeting with Evangelist Ross. And next Sunday, at 10:45, the outreach will celebrate their 32-year anniversary during service. These are the announcements for the week. It was a pleasure bringing your announcements for today and for the month of October. I am Jacqueline Ewu, and I love you all, but God loves you more.
Amen, 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 and thank you, Sister Jacqueline. Excellent. We all know that it's prayer time now. And just to piggyback a little bit on yesterday, well, we had the Mothers Conference. We had 23 churches that had signed up to be in attendance. All of those mothers were here yesterday in white. And it was an awesome sight to see. When you looked out throughout the church, throughout the congregation, you saw all of these beautiful white outfits with these beautiful white hats and fascinators. But what you could feel more so than anything else was the anointing of the Holy Spirit that came in with each and every person that came through our doors. Everybody was on one accord. We all were lifting up the name of Jesus. And we came to magnify the Lord. So at this time, as we prepare to go to the throne of grace, I invite you, if you choose, to come to the altar so you can get a little closer to the fire. But either way, the Holy Spirit is here on this 27th Sunday after Pentecost. And you all know what happened in Pentecost. That was when the Holy Spirit came down to rest upon the breast and caused a stirring throughout. So now as we go to that throne of grace, we say good morning, Father. Good morning, Jesus. Good morning, Holy Spirit. And Father God, I want to stop and thank you for your angelic host that you have encamped around and about each and every one of us, Father God, that's leading us, that's guiding us, that's protecting us, that's keeping us safe, Father God, from all hurt, harm, and danger, both seen and unseen. And Father God, I have to pause right now because I want to be in alliance with what Jesus taught his disciples. He said, we're supposed to ask for forgiveness. So Father God, your word and 1 John 1:9 says that if we ask for forgiveness in earnest, that you are faithful and just, and you will forgive all of our sins and all of our iniquities. So, Father God, I just want to say thank you for forgiveness. forgiveness today. I'd rather ask for forgiveness and not need it than to need it and not ask. So when you hear me pray, I will always, hallelujah, I will always ask for forgiveness, because my thoughts can run rampant sometimes. Sometimes my mouth may say something that offends someone and I'm not even aware. But God, so Father God, I lean and depend and trust in you. Father God, I thank you for you having your Holy Spirit to fill this place. Father God, this is your house. And I thank you that Matthew chapter 18 tells us that where two or more are gathered together in his name, Father God, that you're here in the midst with us. So, Father God, thank you for allowing us into your presence. And, Father God, as I take it a step further, I thank you for what your Son, Jesus the Christ, did for us on Calvary. Father God, you sent him here to love on us, to teach us, and to show us how we are supposed to live and how we're supposed to treat one another. And then, Father, after all of that, he took on the burdens of our sins. And he went to that old rugged cross for us. He suffered, he bled, and he died. He got whipped with those lashes, so that, as Isaiah says, by his stripes we are healed. And then in 1 Peter it says, by his stripes we were healed. So, Father God, I stand in your healing, and I thank you, Father God, for doing what only you can do. Father God, for being God all by yourself. And, Father God, I thank you that the story didn't end with Jesus going to that cross. It didn't end when he got buried in a borrowed tomb. It didn't end when he went down and preached to those captives for those 3 days. Because see, the word tells me that he got up. He got up with all power. Power in his hands. And then he turned around and gave us the keys to the kingdom. But God, but God, but God. Father God, I just want to thank you for your presence here today. Father God, I thank you for our senior pastor, the Reverend Dr. Michael A. Smith. And I thank you, Father God, for his helpmate, Lady Patricia. And I lift up their entire bloodlines. Father God, I thank you for your under shepherds throughout the lands that have laid before you to get a right now, a rhema word from you, Father God, to share with this your people. Father God, touch him, heal him, and Father God, give him what he needs so he can share and pour out to this your people. Father God, I thank you for everyone under the sound of my voice, whether you're here physically, whether you're online or wherever, because the Spirit of God can go wherever he chooses for it to go. He can do whatever he chooses to do. Father God, we thank you for touching, healing, delivering, and setting the captives free. And Father God, we still have a deacon that's missing. Father God, we send the word to Deacon Jesse Carson. Father, we ask that you touch him. Father God, we ask that you bring him home. And Father God, we ask overall that your will be done in all of our lives. Father God, you know what we stand in the need of. So Father God, I just want to thank you for being God all by yourself. Father God, I love you, and I thank you And Father God, to you be all the glory and all the power and all the praises. Father God, again, we love you. We thank you. And I lift and share this prayer. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I'm here to lift up all of our bloodlines and to place us all on the altar at his feet. So, Father God, we can dwell under the shadow of the Almighty. Again, Lord, I love you. I thank you. I bless your holy and your righteous name. In the mighty, in the matchless, in the magnificent and precious name of Jesus, our personal Lord and Savior, I do pray as we all say, amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah. Have your way, Lord. Have your way. And now we will have worship and song. Amen.
Amen. Bless the Lord. We're a little quiet this morning. We're a little too quiet this morning. Come on, put your hands together. Come on, come on, come on, somebody. If you're burdened down, you need to leave it at the altar. If you're burdened down, you need to leave it at the altar. We serve a risen King. We serve a mighty God. Come on, make some noise in this place. He said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. If you be so kind, just stand on your feet right now. If you're able to, come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Lift him up. Lift him up. He's worthy this morning. Come on, somebody. Any praises in the house? Any praises in the house? Yeah! He's worthy. If you make some noise, you'll start feeling better. Come on, lift him up. When I left my home this morning, the sun, the S-U-N wasn't out, but the S-O-N is always out. Come on, somebody. Come on, come on, come on. Just push rewind on your mind and just think back how he's made a way so many times. That's a reason to praise him. That's a reason to give him glory. That's a reason to lift him up. Come on, don't worry about your neighbor. It's an all-by-yourself situation. It's an all-by-myself situation. I'll praise him if I have to praise him by myself. He's been too good. Yeah! Yeah! God is so good. God is so good. Come on, somebody. Any praises in the house? Come on, let this place catch on fire and burn with the Holy Ghost. Come on, catch on fire. I know he's been good. I started not to say nothing, but he's been too good. He's been too good. He's been so good. Worthy is he. Worthy is he. Worthy is he. Worthy is he. Yeah, yeah. Hallelujah. I feel a little better. Don't you feel better? I don't like being somewhere where it's too quiet and the Spirit of God is supposed to be there. Because when fire touch you, you're gonna say something. You're gonna say, ah! The men gonna sing an old song, Trouble in My Way. I have to cry sometimes. Laid awake at night. But that's all right. What's gonna happen? What's gonna happen? Jesus is gonna fix it. Come on, tell your neighbor, Jesus will fix it. Come on, tell somebody else. Come on, tell somebody else. Jesus will fix it. Come on, put your hands together.
have to cry sometimes. So much trouble. I have to cry sometimes. I lay awake at night. But that's all right. Cause I know Jesus. After a while, trouble in my way. I have to cry sometimes. So much trouble. I have to cry sometimes. I lay awake at night. But that's all right. Cause I know Jesus. After a while, one more time. Trouble in my way. I have to cry sometimes. So much trouble. I have to cry sometimes. I lay awake at night. But that's all right. Cause I know Jesus. I know Jesus. I know Jesus. He'll fix it for me. I know he'll fix it for you. And I wonder right now, has he fixed it for you? I want to know if he fixed it for you. He's gonna fix it for you. Then raise your hand. If he's fixing it for you, then wave your hand. He will fix it. Yes, he will fix it. You know his doctor in a hospital. You know his lawyer in a courtroom. He's also bread. He's bread when I'm hungry. He's water too. He's water when I thirst. Because Jesus can fix it. Whatever your problem is, just bring it to Jesus. And then call his name. That wonderful name. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Sweet Jesus. He will fix it. He may not come when you want him, but he's always on time. Yes, Jesus will fix it. Yes, Jesus will fix it. And I ask these questions because Jesus fixed me many, many, many times. I remember 93. I had a heart attack. It took me to my knees. But Jesus stepped in. And I'm well again. Let me tell you, he'll fix it. Yes, he will fix it. And he won't just fix your body, but he'll fix your soul. When I was 12, he fixed my soul. He picked me up. He turned me around. Then he set my feet on solid ground. Can you call his name? Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Jesus will fix it. Jesus will fix it. Jesus will fix it. Jesus will fix it. After Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
Give it up. Give it up. Give it up. We sweat for everything else. Give God a little sweat. Come on, give God a little sweat. Come on and give God a little sweat. Work up some energy. Come on and come on. Give it up for him. In him, I have my strength. In him, I have my joy. In him, I have my passion. In him, in him, in him, in him.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo! All right. Woo! Woo!
I shouldn't have to pump and prime you. Come on, think. Come on and think.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. All right, all right.
Come on, take 30 seconds.
Yes, it's holy ground. Come on.
Take 30 seconds.
Yeah.
Just lift your hands to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Come on, come on, come on.
Thank you, Lord.
Your deliverance could be in you raising your hand. Your deliverance could be just being obedient by what I say.
All right, all right. Yes, hallelujah.
Come on, give him 30 seconds. Tell him how great he is.
Hallelujah.
Come on, tell him how wonderful he is.
Yes,
come on, come on, come on. Talk to him. Fill this place with your worship.
Yes, hallelujah.
Come on, come on. Fill this place with your worship. Don't hide behind the drums and the organ. Come on, tell him how great he is. How wonderful he is. King of kings. The great I am. El Shaddai. Lord of lords. Wonderful counselor. Come on, fill this place. Come on. Come on.
Hallelujah.
From the fruit of your lips. From the fruit of your lips. Lift them up.
I will bless thee, O Lord. I will bless thee, O Lord, with a heart of thanksgiving. I will bless thee, O Lord.
If you know, help me.
I will bless thee, O Lord. I will bless.
Come on, come on. With a heart of thanksgiving. That's it.
I will bless.
A little bit loud.
I will bless thee, O Lord. Yeah, yeah, yeah. With a heart of thanksgiving.
With a heart of thanksgiving,
I will bless.
One more time.
I will bless thee, O Lord. I will bless thee. Oh, I will bless thee, O Lord. With a heart of thanksgiving.
Oh, it's a sweet spirit in this place.
I will bless. Great I am. I will bless thee, O Lord. I will. Hey,
we serve. Now that's how we serve. I want to encourage you, if you're the only one by yourself, give God your best. Give God your best every time.
The deacons come forward. It's time for us to give the Lord back a portion of what he's given us. Hallelujah. Bless you. And after the offering, we will worship in song, but in between, I'm going to come back. And we're going to pray over our senior pastor that's going to bring us the word for this morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Morning.
First, give honor to God,
yes,
who should be the head of all our lives,
yes,
to the wonderful pastor of this great edification. From the crown of his head to the bottom of his feet, Father, touch him.
Yes.
Let him lead us in the right way, Father.
Yes.
Let him teach us in the right way to go, Father.
Yes.
Father, touch the first lady too, Father. Touch her from the crown of her head to the bottom of her feet, Father. Touch the deacon, the deaconess, the mothers, the missionary, the evangelist. Touch the ushers, Father. Touch the music department. Touch them, Father. Father, touch the one that have to give and the one that don't have to give, Father. Let them come around and touch the pan, Father. Just let them touch it, Father. Let them pour out my blessing out the wonderful heavens upon them, Father. Let your will be done, not our, Father. Just Heavenly Father, let your will pour out upon us, Father. Father, bless us this week, Father. Carry us on, Father, so we can come to your house, Father. So that we can come to you, Father, as we know how, Father. Father, I thank you, Father. Father, I thank you, Father. I just thank you, Father. Father, touch me too, Father. Strengthen me where I'm weak at, Father. Touch my family, Father. Father, touch me in a mighty, mighty special way, Father. In your holy and righteous name, Father Jesus Christ, I say amen and amen and amen.
Help me say, I bless you.
don't know about you all, but I feel good. I feel real good. Before we pray over the pastor, I do have a quick announcement I want to update. You all have been seeing the announcements about Grief Share, and we were planning to kick off in October. However, with so many different things happening, that's been pushed out to November. And the way that we're going to do it is we're going to open it up first to Antioch East Baptist Church before we post it online for others to join us. So you will be receiving more information about our actual kickoff date and how we're going to do it here at the church for our family first. Amen? Okay, now, all of you all that's filled with the Holy Spirit, I ask that you point your hands, or at least one hand, towards the man of God that's going to bring us the word this morning. I know he's been laying before the Lord, and especially as he's teaching in the book of Revelation. So we want to say, Pastor Smith, teach us, what the Holy Spirit, has shown you. Teach boldly, and walk in it, as thus says the Lord. Pastor Smith, preach the word. Amen.
All right, church, I know you all were moved by that musical sermon that was given by Reverend Dr. Marshall Smith, so give her a hand, please. Yes. And we will soon have our oratory sermon that will be coming from Dr. Michael, Reverend Dr. Michael A. Smith, pretty soon. But in the meantime, we will have a musical selection by the male chorus. Now, for some of y'all who don't know me, I'll talk my way through a song. So I'm going to invite all of y'all to join us in this particular song. I won't give up, I won't give in. I'm holding on till the end. I'll be steadfast, unmovable, always abide in his will. Lord, say I will. So y'all get ready. Here we go, here we go, here we go.
I won't give up
or give in.
I'm holding on
till the end.
Till the end.
I will be steadfast.
Unmovable.
Always.
Abiding in you.
I say, Lord, come on, fellas.
I'm staying.
All right. Your will. We're going to do that one more time. One more time. Here we go. Y'all help us out.
I won't give up.
Or give in.
I'm holding on.
Till the end.
I will be steadfast, unmovable, always. Always abide in you.
I said, Lord, come on, fellas, Lord.
Lord.
on, fellas, punch it. There you go. We got to do that one more time. One more time.
I won't give up.
Or give in. There we go.
I'm holding on.
Till the end.
I will be steadfast.
Unmovable.
Always abiding in you,
Lord.
I'm staying in your will.
All right, I think we're ready. I'm staying in your will.
I'm staying.
I said I'm staying in your will.
I'm staying.
There we go.
I'm staying in your will.
Said. Yeah, there we go. Here we go. Say it again. I'm staying in your will. Come on, fellas.
I'm staying.
There you go.
I'm staying.
All right, y'all got to make this promise.
Promise you, Lord.
Yeah, there you go. I'm staying. Promise you, Lord. There you go.
Promise you, Lord.
I'm staying. Punch it, fellas. Come on.
Your will.
Yeah, there we go.
I'm staying in your will.
I'm staying. There you go. That's it, fellas. One more time. I'm staying in your will.
I'm staying, Lord.
Come on, promise you, Lord.
Promise you, Lord.
Yes. Said I'm staying.
Your will.
Promise you, Lord.
I am staying. Promise you, Lord.
Yeah, make that promise.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Let's say amen again.
Amen
one more time.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Before I go any further into this sermon, I want to acknowledge two individuals, and we had a high time this morning with baptism. And I have two individuals, and I won't use her middle name again after today, but I first want to ask Brother Gabriel Evans Dorsey to come forward. Amen. Come on, brother. Come on up. It's okay. And I want to read this. And it says to you, Brother Gabriel, the certificate of baptism certifies that Gabriel Dorsey was baptized in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit this 27th day of October in the year of our Lord, 2024, here at Antioch East Baptist Church, located at 2352 Old Rex Morrow Road, Ellenwood, Georgia, 30294, and is signed by Reverend Dr. Michael A. Smith, Senior Pastor, yes. Sister Carolyn P. Griffin, Church Clerk, and also it says you, Gabriel, and this water symbolized baptism that now saves you also, not the removal of dirt from the body, but the pledge of a clear conscience toward God. It saves you by the resurrection of Jesus Christ, 1 Peter 3:21. And Gabriel, you say you already know the Lord and you love him and you want to be baptized. So we want to give you the certificate and letting you know we love you, and we say congratulations, my friend. All right. Now we have a certificate of baptism that certifies that Sister Brenda baptized in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit this 27th of our, the year of our Lord, 2024, at the same place Brother Gabriel has been baptized, and is signed by yours truly, Reverend Dr. Michael Smith, Senior Pastor, Sister Carolyn P. Griffin, Church Clerk. And we just love you, Sister Brenda, and we got the same scripture, and God bless you. Will our courtesy guild please stand? Yes. We want to recognize our courtesy guild who has served 57 years as faithful servants. Yes. As courtesy guild. That means they have to greet you at the front door. No matter how you're feeling, or if you don't want to say anything to anybody, they're going to still say hello, welcome. And it takes a lot to continue to smile and to continue to do God's work. We want to say to you all, 57 years, we salute you all. You all look beautiful, and God bless. Amen. Amen. I want to take this time to recognize some beautiful women of our church. We want to recognize our motherboard ministry. Motherboard, you please stand. And the mothers in waiting as well, will you please stand? Yesterday, we hosted the Mothers Conference, and boy, we had white all in the room. And God had blessed us, and I want to say we were the host church. We want to say to our mothers, to everyone that participated, whatever aspect you participated in, we want to say thank you, and God be the glory. For the first time in 24 years, Antioch East placed, and we placed first. So we want to give the praises to all of those and those that are responsible for our board. And I want you to know it was not rigged. They had to go through and they judged us. We was just smart enough to stay in the Rubik. And God is good. So we thank God for the blessing. Mothers, congratulations and a job well done. We love you all. You may be seated. We need to keep in our prayers. We need to keep Sister Tanya Sherdine and Sister Portia Crum and the Hubbard family. Yes. They lost their father yesterday. Yes. So we have them lifted up, and we continue to keep all those that are bereaved and those that we don't know who have lost family members in this week. We give you all our condolences. Amen? Amen. 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 We're in the book of Revelations, and as I stated, Once we get to the seventh seal, we're going to take a break for a while. But we are in the seventh seal next week. By it's coming up to being time of voting, we want to give a message on that next week. And I just want you all to know that God is a mighty God that we serve. If you haven't registered to vote, please do so. I cannot tell you who to vote for. But I do tell you this, if you don't vote, how can you sit at the table and have conversations? Also, for our future, for our young people, going in that voting booth, letting them know your vote does make a difference. Please, please make sure you register to vote. And you say your vote don't count? How can you prove it if you never voted? So please, 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 I ask you all to go out and vote. We're at a time today in the book of Revelation. This is an interesting one. We have broken a total of, and it was three seals we have broken. And we're looking at it. We had the fourth seal that was taken on. It was four. We've gone through the four flags. We've had our four horsemen come in. Each one of them were different. We know the first horseman came in with a bow and not an arrow because he wanted you to think that he came into this world all about peace. But in actuality, he's the Antichrist. But it's going to come a time in this world we're going to feel like everything is at peace. But then that's the time the Antichrist will strike. People continue to try to figure out who the Antichrist is. We've even labeled some of our officials in high places. That's the Antichrist. The word tells us no man will know who he is, but he will come from the east. So while you're trying to figure that out, you just get a little closer to God and make sure you're ready when he comes. But if you got your business ready already with God, you don't have to worry about the Antichrist because we're going to be already taken away in the rapture. So we had that first flag, and he was dressed all in white. We had our second flagman that came forth, if you remember. He was dressed in red and had the sword. He came because he was going to be slaying people, and he wanted you to know the Antichrist will come from peace and then come to the point that they hold the sword. The third Antichrist, third person that came forth, remember we had the green flag, and it was, that's why it was a flag, not black, because we wanted a black horseman to stand out. That black horseman who came in, remember, he walked in here with a scale of balance, because we're going to go through some times where we're going to see famines, we're going to see where the world will be crumbling right beside us, but the only one that is able to balance out those scales will be Jesus Christ. Our last one, last week, we opened up the fourth seal, and in that fourth seal came the pale horseman. The pale horseman that came forth, you remember, he was the death horseman. He didn't look like any other horseman. He looked like a skeleton coming into the room. And remember, he went up and down the aisles and letting you know that death is all around us. Death is visiting us right now, but it's just the grace of God that is with us. And I know for our young kids, this is really tough for them to understand. And we had our children church last week. It was youth day, so we made sure that they were given something to hold on to. But for all of us that know what reality is that it is coming. We understand that there is a scripture that we have with our fifth seal. And as you see, I hold the scroll. With this scroll is the scroll, a decree. We talked about why is it that they have seven seals and not one, and just to be broken open. The Romans, when they did wheels and everything else, they had them with seven seals. And even with John on the Isle of Patmos, when he was taken up to be able to see what God was bringing forth, we remember no one could touch this scroll but the slain lamb. He was the one that was in the center. We got two lambs, we know that. One looks like white as snow, but the other one looks disfigured, but in reality, he is not. He has seven horns and seven eyes. He has been slaughtered for our blood, but he is the one, because God is all-seeing, and he's all-knowing, and he's all-present. Jesus Christ was the one that could take the scroll. We today are in the sixth chapter, verses 9 through 11. If you don't mind standing, giving reverence to God. The word reads, and when he had opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of them that were slain for the word of God and for the testimony which they held. And they cried with a loud voice, saying, how long, O Lord, holy and true, dost thou not judge and avenge our blood on them that dwell on the earth? And with white robes were given unto every one of them. And it was said unto them that they should rest yet for a little season, unto their fellow servants also and their brethren that should be killed as they were should be fulfilled. Brothers and sisters, you may be seated. We're at our fifth seal being broken. And as I stated, it is only the Lamb of God, which is Jesus Christ, that would be able to break that seal. The fifth seal speaks of those that were martyred, those that gave their life in the name of Christ. We want you to know, before you see the souls that are among you, right with you, you didn't even know they were here. There are souls that are amongst you all that were slaughtered in the name of Jesus Christ. We find in the seventh chapter of Acts, we know about Stephen. It's often said that Stephen was the first to be martyred. He was the first deacon to be killed. Even when Stephen was being stoned, Stephen called out to God and told God, do not charge them for what they're doing to me. Even when he's being killed, he still had mercy and grace on those that were trying to destroy him. He told them, please, Lord, don't. But he looked up into the heavens, and it said that he saw the heavens open because he knew he was leaving this world. There was another who was the first apostle to be martyred, and you can find him in the ushers. You can be seated. Thank you. You can find them to be right there in the 12th chapter. It's the Apostle James. He was killed with a sword, the first one to be martyred. Today, even with the seventh seal, it's part seven, but with the opening of the fifth seal, it's called Under the Altar. That is the sermon for today. It's a continuation of Revelation, part seven, but it's the fifth seal under the altar. We hear that there are souls that are crying out. I want you to understand, these souls are ones that have been killed. They are ones that are waiting to go to heaven. They want to know, when will the time come when we will see those that have done us wrong, those that took our lives, when we see that they have vengeance upon them? But remember what the word says. Vengeance belongs to the Lord. And in God's own time, he will do what needs to be done. So often we want to see a vengeance come upon someone. We say, God, am I going to live to see a payback? We should not be wanting to see a payback on anyone. What we should be doing, we should be praying for one another, praying and asking God to strengthen us. That means if you're wishing ill will on anyone, that means you're not where you're supposed to be. If you want to see a brother or sister fall to their lowest, you're not where you should be. And if anybody want to see you in the same predicament, then they're not where they're supposed to be. But these particular souls are in heaven. They are. They're up under the altar. In the time of Moses, when he was up in Mount Horeb, and also known as Mount Sinai, he asked the Lord, as he was giving him those commandments, and God was giving them to him as he went down, God said, your people down there have been wicked. They're having their own party. And Moses didn't get it at first. But when Moses came down from the mount, Moses saw all that was going on, the God that they had made, everything else, and we knew that he had broken the tabernacle. But Moses also asked, who's on the Lord's side? He gave them an opportunity to get it right. He said, if you're on the Lord's side, you come on over here where I am. But if you're not, you stay where you are. Every one of them that did not come over to where Moses was, it tells us that the earth opened up and the earth consumed them. We think about our lives today, the way we're living. How many of you all are on the Lord's side? How many of you all are ready for what is coming our way? Because we got to know he's a coming. But before he comes, there got to be some things that are taking place. I was talking with Lady Patricia, and she said, this thing is so much about death. It's so much about, how long are you going to stand this again? I said, we got a couple more seals to go. The reason why it's depressing is because it's judgment. It's the final judgment. But God has rewarded the saints. We're already gone. We are already taken up into heaven. When I say we, because I want to include myself in that number, because I don't want to be left behind. But we also often use this. Romans 14 and 8, for whether we live unto the Lord. And whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we live, therefore, or die, we are the Lord's. Brothers and sisters, this right here is just a house. And how many of you all have experienced your house in a life in a physical home has burned right before your very eyes? I want you to know this right here is just a shell. When God calls your name and that soul is gone, this body will decay. I want you to know, I don't care how much people say they love you, but you die on them and see how long they keep you in their house. You die on them and see how long before they say it's time for you to go into the grave. Or if you're going to go ahead and decide that I want to be cremated, you see how long they love you in reference to trying to keep you. But there's somebody love you when it's all said and done, and that's the Lord Jesus. But before it happens, it even tells us and shows us that the spirits, the souls up under the altar, they are human in a way. They say, Lord, when will I see the vengeance come upon them? When were you going to do it, Lord? And Jesus Christ tells them the time will come. See, those that are left behind and have not walked in Christ, tribulation is upon them. But what about those souls? We say to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. We often say that. We often hear that at funerals. But what they're saying is to die and to be released from this body and for your spirit to be taken into the heavens is to be with the Lord. But you got to get there first. We want you to know it also is found in God's word. And I want those that are visiting with us today, and we often say it as sermons. When someone that we love leave this world, it feels good to say they're walking around God's heaven on it. It feels good to say they're sitting at the table with the Lord, and I can just see them sitting back right now in their remote, with their remote control, and sitting back in their lounge chair. I don't know where they found that at, because it doesn't say it in God's word. There are those that say, I know they're walking all around God's heaven right now. I can see my mom. I can see my dad. That's a good thought. But the word tells us in 1 Corinthians 15, it tells us that we all will go to sleep. And in a twinkling of an eye, we will be changed. But it tells us even about the corruptible cannot be with the incorruptible. But what it means, brothers and sisters, there's only one getting up morning. And that's a great day of judgment. So when we hear people say that, what it means is that they want some comfort, and I understand that, but just be blessed assured. Your loved ones are sleeping in the presence of the Lord. Today's sermon, I told you, there are souls that are amongst you right now that have been martyred. I'm asking for the martyred souls to come forward at this time. If you're one of the martyred souls up under the altar, please come forward. Even a mother didn't know her own son was a martyred soul sitting right next to her. We see these souls that are before us, and it says that they're in the altar, and they're asking, Lord, when is the time going to come? When payback is going to show itself? Brothers and sisters, we don't have to worry about payback. All we want to do is get into heaven. But those that martyred want to know that they was not killed in vain. How many of you all are running this race for Jesus Christ, and you want to make sure it's not in vain? Lord, if I live right, if I talk right, if I walk right, Lord, if I love right, and then I don't get into heaven, God, was it all worth it? God is not a liar. God's grace is sufficient. God is the God of all things. If God said it, you better believe it. But I want to tell you, we all talk about, I can't wait till I get to heaven. We say that when we get to heaven, we say this, we're going to put on our robe, and we're going to walk all around God's heaven. But the word tells us when we put on our robe, we know we done made it in. But what Jesus is telling them right now, don't you worry. I just need for you to believe in the word of God. I told you what your reward is. But as we roll these individuals, it is told to us that they're given a robe. And he dressed them, and it says white. So we had to go with white. And it said to this servant right here, you know what? I'm going to do you right. Amen. So I just want to roll after he dressed them in their white robes, and you read the word that God has given, he tells them, all right, brothers and sisters, don't worry, I got it. Now go to sleep. Go to sleep, after all. Go to sleep. Because I got this. I want you to know, brothers and sisters, why they sleeping. God's business is working. Amen. Brothers and sisters, it's just like us. When our bodies leave this world and be placed in the ground, when I say leave this world, because you go and check anybody that's been buried for a certain period of time, you're not going to find skeletons in there. You're not going to find the flesh anymore. But I want you to know your souls will be sleeping. So don't worry, because when God says, wake up, it's going to be time to wake up. And I just wonder with these souls right now. And you see how a couple of them got up and woke up? It's not their time yet. Go back to sleep. Because God tells you to get up. And I want you to know in God's word, we got all these saints that have been killed. It don't tell us the number, but there's many been killed. But I want you to know God's word is true. That's why Jesus Christ went to the cross. That's why he was in a borrowed tomb. That's why on the third day he got up. He walked this earth for 40 days. And after 40 days, he said, I got to go. They said, don't leave us, Jesus. He said, I got to go. Because where I'm going, I'm going to send the comforter for you to be all right until I come back. I want you to know, brothers and sisters, be ready, because he's a coming. Mothers dressed in their white, they was in it yesterday. But the mothers won't need the hats when they get on the other side. When that great getting up morning, they're going to be wearing crowns because of what it tells us. But they're going to cast their crowns because they're going to let Jesus know, you are holy. That's the fifth seal. Brothers and sisters, I want you to know they gave their life for Jesus. There may come a time when you're going to have to stand up and give your life. We've seen it so much before. What about the young lady in Columbine, she said, they asked her, do you love Jesus? Yes, I do. And she lost her life. She's probably one of those going to be at the altar. You don't know who's going to be there. There's so many of us we are going to face a weapon looking right at us. They're going to say, do you love Jesus? You're going to make a decision. But I tell you one thing. When that great getting up morning comes, those that are asleep will be awakened. My brothers and sisters that are asleep, wake up. You can wake up now. Because wake up. Because Jesus promised us. He promised us eternal life. Wake up. And not only wake up, you can stand up and give God. Thank you, Jesus. You remember me, because I'm just nobody trying to be somebody. But I love Jesus. And because of who Jesus is, we give him all the glory. How many of you all want to go to heaven? How many of you all want God to see your name and call your name? If you love Jesus, stand up and give him some praise. If you love Jesus, let him know I'm leaning and trusting in you. God, I give you my hallelujah. I give you my best obedience. God, I give you everything that I have. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. Lord, I'm just a rock in a weary land. You are a shelter in the time of a storm. You're my battle like in the time of battle. But thank you, Jesus. Brothers and sisters, they got there. Jesus thing. That God thing and Jesus thing will be the thing that gets you into heaven. Amen. But if you don't want to go, that's all right, because you got a choice. But I'm going to tell you something. I don't do well in heat, so I don't need to be going anywhere else. But to the Holy something for me. Those saints that are lined up right now, I need for you all to take a couple of these aisles. You can position yourself and stand anywhere in these aisles. You didn't know you had to do that today when you put on your robes. But if you can go, Ariana, you take the center. Shalon, you take. Go get them. All right. Shalon, come up on this side. Not this side. Go over to the other side. We need one over there, all the way over. You're walking for Jesus. Ariana, you can stay in the center so they can see you. Brothers and sisters, I can't buy Jesus for you. Brothers and sisters, I can't push Jesus on you. Jesus paid the price. He paid the price so we can have eternal life. But you can keep running, you can keep playing, you can keep hiding. But in the end, you're going to have to answer to him. But I'd rather answer to him and he says, well done, my faithful and servant. Well done, my good and faithful servant. Rather than him to say, depart from me, I know you not. You don't want your mommy and your daddy to say, I don't know you, get away from me. I want my daddy to say, he knows me. And when it's going to happen, you give your life to him. Dr. Martin, you to watch these saints that are in the aisle in their white robes. They had to give up something in order to be something.
Yes.
They gave their life to Christ. The time is now, brothers and sisters. Never thought I'd be one of those kind of preachers saying the time is now. But the time is now. If there's anybody that want to give their life to Christ, come on right now. If you want to rededicate yourself, come on right now.
Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll
fly away.
Help me say, oh.
If not, you may take your seat. Is there anybody over here? If not, you may take your seat. Is there anybody here? If not, you may take your seat. Is anybody here? You may take your seat. Church, I'm just glad to do this, and we're going to go ahead and do our benediction after this, but our brother's home. And I just want us to just put a covering over him. And I'm going to ask Evangelist Nayutha Ross to come forth and just lead a prayer with Dion, Brother Dion, and ministers and deacons, I ask you all, and all the ones in the white robe, let's come on down. Let's put our hands over this brother or get in our circle. Hey, Patricia, come on, we got to pray over him.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we come and say thank you for all your many blessings, God. Oh, God, we bless your name today because you're worthy to be praised. Your word don't stand, God. You said before heaven and earth pass away, your word is going to stand. Even the one that's dressed up in the robes today, God, in the name of Jesus, God, you're getting us ready, God. You're getting us ready in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, you know, I thank God for this young man right here. Been knowing him all of his life. God, I pray in the name of Jesus, God, that you continue to use him for your glory. In the name of Jesus, God. God, I pray, God, that he will move, reign, and abound wherever he go. God, let him stand up and let the world know wherever he go, he is a child of God. And God, you say you would not hold no good thing from him, God. All he got to do is trust in you and believe in your word, God. Standing on your promise, God, like never before, in the name of Jesus. And God, the circle that we are in today, God, we ask you to bless each and every one in this circle, God, in the blessed name of Jesus. Even the one that's sitting in the pew, God, touch them all, God. Let them not be the same when they came through the doors. Let them go out rejoicing, telling the world, I know my Redeemer lives, and he lives in me. In the name of Jesus. Now, God, I know he got to go back home. I know Dion got to go back. And, God, I pray traveling grace and mercy. Woo! Yes, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Now, I know his mother's in the audience. Stanley, see, I know you out there. And I pray God mercy upon you today. Lord, I pray for the grandmother today, Mother Carruthers. In the name of Jesus and all of the whole entire bloodline, God, we pray mercy upon this young man. God, you know what? All of the men and women out there fighting in the name of Jesus. Lord, be with them, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we trust you, God. We don't have nowhere else to go but to you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for the service today. Thank you for our pastor today. Thank you for the service today. Thank you for the anointing and the Holy Spirit that reign, ruling about in our hearts in the name of Jesus. And we'll never, 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 never say no because your word is true. In the name of Jesus, we will give you the glory and the honor and the praises because it belongs to you. In Jesus' name, God bless you. God bless you. Amen and amen. Amen. Thank you.
All right. We give God all the praises. Like I said, Revelation is not one of those going to be jumping all around, but it is one that leaves you to thinking. And we thank God for each and every one of you all. We cover you all. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And if you don't mind standing at this time as we prepare to depart from one another. We may depart with the body, but let our spirits always be intertwined in giving God the praises. Let us pray. Righteous and holy God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the pouring of our male chorus and our minister of music and our drummer. We thank you for all those on the platform of the media. We thank you for all of these beautiful members, these visitors, God. Lord, we just ask that you hear their cry. You know their needs and you know their desires. God, you know what they're going into. You know what they're into right now. You know what they're coming out of. But I thank you. Thank you, Lord, for loving us so. You didn't have to do it, but you did. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. As I leave you with the benediction, I also leave you with this. The grief share is not only for someone that loses someone. You could have lost a job. You could have lost other things that got you going through. I promise you, once you're into that grief share, a lot of people carrying a lot of grief we got to get off of us. You'll be surprised what you get out of that grief share. And we'll be the first one in Ellenwood of any church or surroundings to have a grief share. And I promise you, it's amazing how it does the healing. Leave with you the benediction. May the Lord watch between me and thee while we're absent one from another. Don't forget to pray. Little prayer, little power. But if we back it up, no prayer, no power. Much prayer, much power. But we're Antioch East Baptist Church. We believe in exceptional prayers by saying the name of Jesus. Jesus. Jesus, give us exceptional power. God bless you all and be with you all. Amen. 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 Amen.